one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through.
We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the New Orleans Saints. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in week 14. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. First carry now for the rookie from SC. It's Ronald Jones. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Let's go now.
Second down, Winston steps away to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by a former first-round pick, Patrick Robinson. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And the tackle there by Quan Alexander.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And he'll get this back. To the 32-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Cameron Jordan in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down.
Hey, stop. Ready.
Now Jameis on second down. Jackson's got it over the middle. Oh, he's got a little daylight. John Jackson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Extra point good by Catanzaro, and that makes the score 7-0. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Stop before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 14. Shotgun now for Breeze. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. His first catch, good for 14 there and a first down. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 43. Breeze now on 1st down. Buying time to his left. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Second down, here's Breeze. And this is a catch by Ted Ginn. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. Breeze to another longtime vet, Ginn, for the New Orleans first. Breeze now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's 1st and 10. On 1st down, Breeze. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Winston and the Bucs take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now a second down throw for Winston. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Winston on 3rd and 2. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. So they took a shot there on 3rd down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
Well, you've got a receiver here who's got 1 touchdown already in this first quarter, and they were trying to double his pleasure there, wanting to continue to go to the guys already gotten into the end zone. But good coverage to make sure that this time it fell incomplete.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Now it's Ginn. Ted Ginn's gonna go! Touchdown, New Orleans! Ted Ginn, 81 yards! And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. They get the stop defensively, force the punt, they score without their offense even stepping on the field.
I remember playing and playing on special teams and teasing the guys on offense, like, look, you don't even worry about it. You guys just hang out over there. We'll bring this one all the way back and get the points we need. In this case, they actually got that done.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field.
And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Winston and the Bucks take over now. 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. Good move at the 30. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
They go play action. Winston, they'll roll him out right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he slides to avoid the hit. For a big guy, Jameis sure can move. Did a nice job there picking up the first down with his legs. He is tough to bring down, Jameis Winston. Charles, I remember calling a baseball game of his. He played baseball at Florida State, too. And you saw his legs, tree trunks, sprayed in to those baseball pants. I said, how could anybody bring this guy down?
And that's part of the beauty of his game, because he has that toughness, that thick body. He may not beat you sprinting, but he's real sharp with his mind, and he knows how to get away from people.
Sonic! Easy.
Hey, stop. Ready? Winston out of throw on 1st down. He's going to air one. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll be down deep into New Orleans territory. A gain of 39 that time.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
On first and 10, Winston. And that is caught by Jackson for a Buccaneer touchdown. Deshaun Jackson, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bucs are able to strike for six. Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And that makes the score 14-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit? Like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week?
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Thomas, the intended target. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Now a first down carry by Jones. Oh, what a juke into space. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
From the gun, Winston. This will be caught at about the 5. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal.
Everyone has their strengths, able to move to their right or their left, being able to throw the football. So that means you've got to work on both because you never know which way you're going to get flushed by pressure. In this situation, able to escape to his left and makes an accurate throw.
One back in the game, that's Jones, second and goal. Jameis to throw it. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Chris Godwin that time, and it's third and short.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's going to have to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. Third and goal, Winston. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th. Well, you throw it this close to the goal line, usually you're thinking touchdown. Here they actually completed the lose yardage.
When you're this close to the goal line, you have to anticipate that maybe you're going to see a defense that you can make a case that there's 11 in the box. There's just no room. So I'm with you. You've got to find a way to push things downfield a little bit. Any type of space is better than what we just saw there. And that end result, not one that's satisfactory to them.
And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Brent Hines. And nearly a touchdown. touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Following the interception, Winston. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Big O.J. Howard, his intended target. And it's second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. 3 touchdown passes now in the ball game for Jameis Winston. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Extra point good by Catanzaro. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Saints, they trot their offense out here. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see when they decide to do a play caller. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Bree's going to throw. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. 7 yards on the play, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 13.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Ready? You ready?
Now Breeze on third down. And he'll go right back to Thomas, complete again. Breeze on the hook up to Thomas for the New Orleans first.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time. Now Breeze lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
With no running backs in the backfield to help. Pass protect. All the receivers in their patterns. It's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
Pitch it out to Jones. Oh, a nice spin. And he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28. Run. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Sheldon Rankins. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Winston needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucks up on third and long. Working out of the gun, Winston. He's going to air one out. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And that will push this lead up to 20 now. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board. Ended up settling for three.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though? When they only gave up the field goal, and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive, a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Being chased out left, and he fires one incomplete. He was looking for his fullback there, Zach Line, at its third down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
To throw is Breeze. He is going to find Hill here. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Breeze now to throw. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
It's brought in right side by Gim. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. Here's Breeze, and an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
Sometimes it's just not your day. Here's another failure right there on third down.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Breeze going to sneak it. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
Get set.
Now this time, Breeze will throw. Now Breeze lost the football. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. He already had the one fumble lost, so now two fumbles lost here in this first half.
Not setting the pace the way that you want it done. I mean, here in the first half, already twice the ball's come out and hit the turf. Got to find a way to take care of it. Otherwise, they may have to start thinking about maybe someone different at that position.
And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now, there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, D Do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No,
not at all.
Temporarily out of field goal range now as they come up on a second and long after the holding call. Here's Winston. Throw right side, caught by O.J. Howard. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. That is caught at the 7. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Jameis Winston with his 4th touchdown pass of the afternoon. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And a rout is on here in this first half. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
This thing way downfield, and my goodness, another interception. Vernon Hargreaves with a pick, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
The left side completion to Jones. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Winston now over 200 yards already in this first half. It's first and 10.
Hey, stop. Let's go.
A first down throw for Winston. Dancing to his left. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. So we've hit halftime here in Tampa with the Bucs out in front. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at his 4. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But
this is I'm doing it,
though.
This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Jumpy on the right side of the line.
Sometimes when you're on the end, a little bit farther away from the ball, any type of movement will get you to jump, and that's exactly what happened there.
And now they face a second and 6 after the penalty. On second down, here's Breeze. And now here's another interception. Picked off near the 34. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown 6 interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it 3 times. Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10. They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. And now running right through it. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Second down, Winston. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. O.J. Howard, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the interception by the Bucs D leads to a touchdown.
And that's just another in a long line of passing touchdowns for him today. To say that he's been on fire would definitely be an understatement.
Extra point good by Catanzaro, and the lead will swell by 1 more. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at the 3. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Saints coming out now to take the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Breeze now. Catch here, left side, Thomas. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
Hey, kill, kill!
Breeze hands to Ingram. And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. Now Breeze. And my goodness, another interception. He's picked off near his own 48. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
Let's go.
They find some open field here. And another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on a tackle. And that's going to tack on 15 more. The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. After the penalty, it's Jones. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Green, triple C. Ready, swing that.
On second down, it's Jones. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. The Bucs on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This will be third and six.
I got 11.
Off the play fake. Winston steps away to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Jones. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
Here's another 2nd and goal, this time from half the distance closer. They come out here in the eye. They'll try again with Jones. And he takes it into the end zone across the chalk. Now there is a flag down, but I think that's offsides on the defense.
Yeah, I think that's going to stand, partner.
Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And that will extend this big lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Elsewhere, a third quarter score from NRG Stadium in Houston. And the Colts have scored to move in front. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, 1st and 10 at their own 27. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last 2 drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
Easy.
Breeze to throw on 2nd down. Throw left side, taken in by Meredith. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow,
and they can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Gerald McCoy in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And look at this, it's a fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt, it doesn't work out.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, they look like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. The give is to Jones. And he's got some space here. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. That good for 19 and a first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Back now in Tampa, and this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. For it on first and goal. And they get him down at the one. He had the broken tackle, but ultimately could not get into the end zone. A good run, 8 yards there, and it'll be second and goal. Second and goal from the one.
Sonic! Ready! Flag 22!
He's going to get it running right. And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And this Buccaneer offense, they're running away with this one. So another score there. And often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching, and he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play, because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. Throwing now is Breeze. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Thomas. 70th catch for him on the year. And like so many others, this goes for a first down. Breeze now 6-for-6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. On 1st down, Breeze. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Here's Breeze to throw. And some room to maneuver. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Extra point good by Catanzaro, and the lead will swell by one more. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. So Breeze going to lead the Saints up here, 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They start the drive on the ground, Kamara. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. Alvin Kamara really settling into the league in his second season. And, of course, he came out of Tennessee, but not a lot of people remember he started at Alabama.
He did and got caught in that big mix of running backs at Bama. And they like those bigger, thicker runners, those guys who can break down defenses through the middle. Alvin Kamara ended up leaving Alabama, going to a junior college for a while. I believe he went to Hutchinson Junior College before matriculating at Tennessee and finding his way to the NFL, where he is now a star.
Now Breeze. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, 2nd down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Oh, design run for their wideout. And not much doing. He'll get this only up to about the 36. Tackle made by Chris Conte. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Saints on 3rd down, 2-for-5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. From the gun, it's Breeze. He sets to fire deep. That's caught inside the 20. A big-time play there for New Orleans. 46 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Now Breeze. Buying time to his left. And avoids the contact by sliding. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Here we go.
On 2nd down, Kamara. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
That's caught. It's Thomas. And he picks up the 1st as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. Give him a gain of four, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. Escaping the pressure right, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Levante David, and a short return to the six-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Give to Jones. And he'll take this forward only up to about the seven. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
A boost here to start the drive. After the penalty, it's first and five. Now Jones, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. They'll step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Well, they didn't really have to earn that first down, did they?
Well, they haven't earned much, are they? Back-to-back penalties. First was first and five, and now they give them a first down.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. Again, it's Jones. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. A gain of three, second down. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
Here's Jones. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
This is Jones. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Yeah, let me puff out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. But that was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
Hey, boys, we got four down. Plays hot. Plays hot.
Now a handoff. Running left is Jones. Find room inside the 40. And down right around the 37. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
They give it off here to the tight end, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it.
Splash. Think about posting her on the ground, man, delete her. Whole gang in the field, we don't. don't do bleachers. Think about both not on the ground, man, the leader. Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers.